Alrighty, here we go. So we'll do three randoms again for each side. This time we'll be away. So one, two, three. Ooh, the Jacksonville Jaguars. One, two, three. Against the Minnesota Vikings. Interesting. Okay. Remember all Madden for the difficulty? 8 minute quarters, no accelerated clock. And Minnesota, the Minnesota Vikings. Today, from US Bank Stadium, it's like something out of Star Wars.
Dan Bailey to kick off for Minnesota. This is Madden NFL 21 on EA Sports.
And a decent return out to the 27 yard line.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 27 yard line.
A first carry now for Thompson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
First down yardage. Ooh, Chris Thompson already setting the tone.
A gain of 14. First down, Jacksonville.
Have LaVishka Chenault. And the drag.
Throwing on first down is Minshew. This is Chenault on the receiving end.
Minshew's pass.
Comes 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
It's a gain of
able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three.
48-yard line.
Here's Minshew.
Wow.
An interception here. Ooh, on the opening drive.
Good thing that was a defensive lineman jumping up. Not good catch ratings.
So complete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. From the gun, Minshew to throw. Able to complete this to
LaVishka Chenault.
Oh. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 39. 12 yards.
Let's run it up with Robinson.
Rolling. It's another first down. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They run on first down as they're able to get this forward for about four.
James Robinson. Hopefully we get him over 100 yards today. He's one of my favorite players in the NFL.
Second down now. It's Robinson.
Running like that, probably won't.
At the 34.
The ball carrier.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know they're securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Out of the gun is Minshew. Got a man out of the backfield. It's Chris Thompson.
Fuck.
And a loose football. And the Vikings pick up the football.
Minshew's pass complete. A fumble on the play.
And it's overturned. Awesome, we didn't fumble. First down. Keep it on the ground here with James.
On first down, Robinson. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Tackle made there by the UCF man, Mike Hughes. Throwing on second and eight. Minshew on the slant.
Face mask. Anthony Exum. Oh, my gosh.
Shy of the 10. 15 yards on the play. First down. Now first and 10 at the 11.
Keep it out of the hands of Chris Thompson there. Throw it on a streak to Chark right there. Circle, because he's in the slot.
Minshew sets to throw.
Touchdown.
DJ Chark for the Jags touchdown.
17, DJ Chark.
DJ Chark. There to make
they didn't have anyone on the line press covering him, so didn't have to worry about something on the line of scrimmage taking him off his route. And since the safety was so far back, if you throw it on a quick pass right to him, it'll be wide open. Nobody can get to him fast enough.
Josh Lambeau to get.
Lambeau now after the touchdown. He'll kick this one away. Taken in the end zone.
Pioneer Airways. I wonder if that's like Mohican Airways from F is her family. Probably not.
Minnesota now ready for their next possession. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25.
Taven Bryant.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook.
So mainly we got to shut down Dalvin. Shut down Dalvin, force him to pass. I'd rather have Kirk Cousins throwing than Dalvin Cook running all over the place.
Cousins gives way to Cook. They'll only get a couple up to the 30.
Anthony Hamilton?
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
That'll be complete to Cook.
Oh.
Past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Send everyone.
The screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Brings up second and seven.
Off the play fake. Cousins. And that's taken in. It's BC Johnson. First down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 34-yard line. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
First and 10 at the 34-yard
line. Draw play, Cousins to Cook. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They've got second and 12 from the 36.
At the Jaguars, 36-yard line.
Working out of the gun, Cousins. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
All right, here we go, third down.
Coming up on the drive, third and five.
Third and five.
From the gun, here's Cousins. This is Johnson, he's got it. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 16. 13 yards as the Vikings pick up the first down. Back to the ground, Cook. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now Cook. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. The Jags with five in the secondary now on third down.
Brings up third and nine.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete.
Kept him to three.
So
keep Shelbert back in case it's a fake.
Bailey's kick is good. And that'll do it for the first quarter of play. 7-3 the score.
Wow. One possession each for a quarter.
Dan Bailey to kick off for Minnesota.
Taking it about the one. And the tackle going to be made right there.
Wow, I thought I was at the 24. Laid a free yard.
At their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Looking to throw it. Minshew. Connection made with Chenault.
He was going back, and then Johnson hit him forward.
For five. It's third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short.
James Robinson.
Going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open. That makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
Just a yard on the run.
Punt
there,
it. Keep it more realistic.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on fourth and one. Let's see what they decide to do.
Ow.
He's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been.
Shouldn't have hit him.
A little too amped up there. Got to him before he had a
definitely
chance to
worth
catch
it.
Him.
Another example of players in tough spots getting the protection that they deserve. Got to make sure that he's able to catch the ball before you get to it.
Running on first down is Cook, but he didn't find much there. Call it a gain of three. Second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven. At the fourth.
Throwing is Cousins. That one into the hands of Thielen. Complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all.
Taking
Josh Jones in on the stop.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at their 49.
Second down, Cousins. Jackson with a completion over the middle. Some extra space following the display of power. Down just inside the 45. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Third and three.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And they're going to
make it. Oh, we stopped him.
Maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard.
And one.
Cousins to throw for it on four.
Shit.
Find its receiver. That's Chad Beebe. They're able to keep the drive alive. 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Josh Allen.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
It's now second and six at the 30-yard line.
Cousins to throw it. And that one goes incomplete.
Fumble. Come on now.
It wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. The Vikings on third down. They've hit two for four thus far. This will be third and six. Now Cousins.
Nope. No, no, he did not.
Be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Let me challenge that shit.
It's number four for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
I guess so.
Settle for three last drive, hoping this second go around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Cook.
Oh, wow.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. 24 yards. And the Vikings.
Dalvin Cook is definitely not a boxer.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit. But for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball, too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker.
Okay, here we go. Jaguars on the offensive.
Taking it about the run. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
That's that stick action.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And last time, not only
hopefully can break it outside.
Turned into 6 points.
Yep.
They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over,
that was to the 41. Oh my gosh. What is up with this?
That's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Minshew with a throw complete to Shenault. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside.
Ooh,
the 30. Getting it to him.
LaVisca.
Pays off big time. That winds up going for 31. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Minshew.
Oh,
nearly
no.
A disaster there on the check down.
At least that wasn't a pick. Fuck. Hey.
Incomplete.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Shotgun handoff to Thompson.
Had to watch the linebacker see which way he was going to bite.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And able to find Conley. And he picks up the first down yard.
That was a
weird
ending.
He takes this one down to the 15. Time rolls around. Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. To the left side here for Eifert. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Brings up second. Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync.
Gonna keep it on the ground.
Communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
It's a minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Third down.
This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third.
Punch it in with James.
They'll run here with Robinson. And he will get this into the end zone for
yes,
a
sir.
Touchdown. A 6 yard touchdown run. And once again, the Jaguars are back out in front.
Duck, duck, deuce.
A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded in the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it.
25-yard line.
And you see Devin Cook in the offense heading back out. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call?
Is that a timeout by me?
The long handoff. Serve as your running play that way.
Cool.
As well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here?
Wow, that was hella holding on me.
Big call coming on third down.
Oh, defense. P.I. Yeah, fuck.
Thought they were going to force a fourth down. Instead, P.I. gives him the first.
And that's frustrating because you think you've taken them really deep into the count, haven't you? Instead, you've got to start all over. That can really, really be demoralizing.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Again, it's Cousins.
Oh, wow, I fucked up. Almost had the sack.
And a 5 yard gain gets him to the 42. So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. And he's gonna be
okay, we gotta get a play for a loss here. Take him out of field goal range.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
5 yard line.
They'll throw again. Cousins.
Uh-oh.
Over the middle here to Rudolph. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
35-yard attempt.
Fuck.
And Bailey able to knock it through. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So yes, they'll still be
we like to keep it interesting,
but
folks.
The deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in his last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that they feel somewhat safe that
wow.
Pop and turn into a big play.
Oh, well.
That's what you usually run in this situation.
Four verticals. Hit the nay-nay, sir.
Why not? Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
We now proceed to the start of the second half.
Or whatever that was. Fucking, I don't even know.
So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. The Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. Take it in the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll start by handing it off to Dalvin Cook. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
O'Neal.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Cousins. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield.
Got it.
And they will take over possession of the football.
Sidney Jones.
Intercepted by the Jaguars.
So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live. And now they're
hurry up
out of this hole.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brought down behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2. Brings up second and 12.
Again, it's Robinson.
Oh.
Get this up past the 45 to the 47. That's what they needed. It's an 8-yard gain, and now third and 4 suddenly doesn't look so bad.
Chark over the middle on the slant.
From the gun, Minshew to throw. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. Minshew and Shark on the hookup. Their first down, Jacksonville.
Jaguars.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down. They run. Robinson. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
The tackle made at the
I don't know about Robinson getting 100 anyway.
And maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
The ball carrier.
An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down.
Game on the play.
They'll run it now with Robinson. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. And give him about 3 as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
He was taken down at the 22.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. Well, let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains. That means they're punting the ball.
Wow. That was terribly inaccurate.
When you're playing defense. Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Oh, one-hander.
Chenault. One-handed. What a catch. 63 yards receiving for him now. And that last catch, good enough for a first down. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Escaping the pressure right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
On second down.
That was a face mask, bro. Drug me down by that shit.
Stopped at the 11.
Robinson, the ball carrier.
Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense.
The Vikings!
Yeah! On third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down.
Hit him with 3, hit him with 3, hit him with 3. 17-13.
The score, Jaguars 17.
So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job.
420. Left them third. That's funny.
Mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
Kirk Cousins and the Vikings offense back on the field. And he comes out on the heels of an interception he threw last time they had the ball.
Yeah, and you know, the quarterbacks that I know, they
are the sack.
Best. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar.
Kayvon Chaisson.
Kayvon Chaisson.
Kayvon.
Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Dumps this off over the middle. Call it a gain of 3. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
Third down.
Third and long for Cousins. The throw complete to Beebe. And he's
going
to be brought down short of the first at about the 31-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. That'll be a 41-yard punt, 4 yards there on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10.
See what kind of defense they're running. If they move, it's blitz, man. If they don't, it's zone.
Just the one touchdown pass. I think he's managed the game well, though.
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you judge how big a mistake and when it occurs. No interception so far. They'll like that.
Oh, first. Hey, James just might get 100, actually.
On the tackle. Are you touched?
A gain of 12.
He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
He's touched. Like a Boy Scout.
One on first down. It's Thompson. And give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
34.
Again, a run with Thompson. He's got the first down and more inside the 40.
Number 34 on the carry.
Almost 8 yards of carry.
Sometimes
shit.
It's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away.
Even 5 a carry.
From busting this open, that's a good start for him.
A gain of 5
runs on this drive.
We're going to be either looking for Chenault at triangle in the slot or Robinson going out on the motion. Probably going to be Chenault.
Out of the gun is Minshew. This is Chenault on the receiving end.
Minshew.
7 yards, the pickup there.
LaVisca.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
The ball carrier.
That play gets him 6 yards and sets them up with a first and goal.
Jacksonville.
Here's Minshew. That's complete right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A good rally to the
hit him with the dive.
Only a yard and it's second down.
Why not?
The Vikings 8-8.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line.
Oh, wow.
And he's going to be met at
Tyler Eifert's injured. Well, that's a surprise. No, I'm just playing. He's injured quite often.
Third and goal. Third and goal now, mere inches from pay dirt. Takes it in. Touchdown.
Chenault.
Jacksonville. From 8 yards out. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead.
Excuse me.
And this is what coaches talk about. Never being satisfied. No matter what the lead, always trying to increase it. You never know what can happen in this NFL.
And he's able to put it through. A 10-play drive that time. And it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville.
Josh Lambeau.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away.
And he fields it in the end zone. And as we come out here on defense, the Jacksonville Jaguars are up 24-13 over the home team, Minnesota Vikings. Here we go, fourth quarter. Almost sacked him.
That catch good for only a couple. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line.
Brings up second and eight.
From the gun, here's Cousins. He's going to get this one down to Cook. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
Oh.
Oh,
knocked him out cold.
So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line, that's where they'll take over. Obviously, you got to hold on to the
look at this shit.
I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
He kicked it with his foot.
A lot of the time, we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football. And they still find ways to knock it free.
James Robinson, over 100 yards. Beasting.
14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of five.
The ball carrier.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads. Bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Soft through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now.
Harrison.
The Jaguars on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. They're up against a third and one situation. And they work this near the five.
Ooh, down to the six.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind.
The one, two.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. They'll contain him to just four. Second down from the two now. Second and goal.
Option.
And he'll go backwards, losing yards to the five. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's third down.
Well, that's going to bring up a big call now because he is unable to make the play himself on second down. Now you just have to wonder, will they keep the ball in his hands on third down?
Well, let's see where they turn on third and goal from the five. Back in the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
The kick by Lambeau is
good. Make it 14 points.
Up to 14.
27.
So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown. Probably
you know what sounds good? Is that Flintstones movie. I kind of want to watch that.
Got points. So
the first one, though, with John Goodman. Not that second one. Viva Rock Vegas. Golly, that one was definitely not as good as the original. Oh, hey, Brood. Oh, hey, Barn.
It's like,
Rock Vegas wasn't good. Forget who played Betty and Wilma.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Should get Tony Romo to commentate these games. Strip sack.
Corral this one, and Minnesota will keep possession. Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second
just
half,
gotta
the thing they needed was to lose the possession.
Get Kirk Cousins to throw, remember?
Because it could have been lost there. They're
looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted.
Pick six.
Josh Lambeau lining up.
And that one will
if you're a Vikings fan, sorry, if you're a Jags fan, which I'm sure there aren't very many of you, you're welcome.
Closed, locked, reinforced.
Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. takes this about 5 yards deep. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it. And now out comes Minnesota. And that last pick six may have been the backbreaker as they now face a three-score deficit in the fourth quarter. They need points quickly. Here's a throw that's taken
trying to take his legs out.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They'll come up now second and four from the 31.
A six-yard pickup brings up second and four.
Working out of the gun, Cousins. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
A first down for Minnesota. Cousins finding Thielen. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains.
Wow, that really is his favorite target.
And another first. So in Jacksonville
territory, aren't they winning?
Now here's a first and 10 at the 43. Cousins throw complete to Thielen.
He said, get off me, stiff-armed him. Fuck me up.
Goes for 24 yards. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. On the carry, it's Cook. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
At the 12-yard line. A 7-yard pickup brings up
throwing on second and three. Cousins. And wants the football. It's almost picked up. And the Jags grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
By Jacksonville.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there.
Never know.
Handoff to start it out. Robinson. And he'll get two or three out of that one as that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They'll run again here with Robinson. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11.
Just give James more yards.
About 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. And he's going to be taken down here still a couple yards short of the first. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go?
They did go for it earlier on the 41-yard line. So I remember.
On fourth down, Minshew.
Well, fuck that up.
Like he had it and dropped it. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Well, Charles, I guess the only thing I can think there is they've got a three-score lead, and they're saying, well, we're not going to lose this, so let's... And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson.
I'm not even mad. That guy's on my fantasy team, so...
Are able to cut into that deficit.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a two-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt for the two-score game. They're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
Whew. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one.
Ooh, Harrison Smith is in the zone. Too bad I'm not going to run it near him.
And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. They'll keep it on the ground. Robinson, and he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with a minute six left to go in the game. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10.
All right, and that'll do it for their timeouts, and basically just run out the clock from here.
Just over a minute to go in the game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of six. The heavy set out there. Three tight ends in the formation for third and three. And it's third. On the run, it's Robinson. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
The tackle made at the 24-yard line.
Minshew sets to throw.
I had to.
His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jaguars had six to their lead.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about pulling on the reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not their head coach's makeup.
They got that sucker shit inside their DNA.
You stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
Josh Lambeau to kick.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Taken in the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Osborne elects not to return it. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge. It's almost a coach.
And that'll do it here in Minnesota. The Jacksonville Jaguars, 41. Oh, here we have another play. And that'll do it here in Minnesota. The Jacksonville Jaguars, 41. The Minnesota Vikings, 20. Oh, beat their ass. James Robinson, 134 yards. Thank you, and good night.